to go in the 130th Preakness, and they're off. And Greeley's Galaxy got squeezed back at the start once again. Wilco comes away in between horses. There goes Closing Argument with some early speed. Scrappy T down toward the inside. Going Wild, he's going to be caught very wide. And High Limit is up there too. Going Wild trying to make his way to the inside. But High Limit is there, and now High Limit's got the lead. Going Wild alongside second. Scrappy T just in behind lead and running in third. Galloping Grocer fourth on the outside. Closing Argument is now fifth. Wilco three wide and sixth. And then it's High Fly who rides the rails with Jerry Bailey. They're seventh now. Sun King is eighth, followed by Greeley's Galaxy. Off poorly, he's now ninth toward the inside. A Fleet Alex is racing in tenth. Giacomo is 11th, just as he did in the Derby. He's well behind in the early going. Then a break of three. Back to Longshot's Malibu Moonshine, followed by Hal's Image on the early trailer's Noble Causeway. The half went in 46 seconds flat. Not that frantic pace we had in the Derby, but this pace is strong nonetheless. And it's High Limit going at it down the back stretch here with Going Wild. High Limit short lead. Going Wild, Scrappy T under a long hold there, right in behind the lead and running third with the half mile to go. Galloping Grocer has asked for more run. Bailey has taken High Fly to the outside. Closing Argument trying to pick his way through in between horses. Greeley's Galaxy is gaining ground with a big move there down toward the rail. And then a Fleet Alex, he's bottled up down toward the inside, followed by Sun King. Giacomo's got a lot to do, and less than 3 furlongs to do it. He's 10 lengths behind and caught in some traffic now, and Scrappy T comes away with the lead, but a Fleet Alex is taking a bullet. Oh, Scrappy T blew the turn, and a Fleet Alex, Jeffrey Rose, almost fell out of the saddle. A dramatic occurrence at the top of the stretch. Here's a Fleet Alex who has come on to take the lead. Scrappy T blew the turn, and he's second on the inside, and it's 5 lengths back. Giacomo will manage only to be third. They're coming down to the finish, and in dramatic style, a Fleet Alex who almost fell at the top of the stretch has won the Preakness by 5 lengths. Scrappy T was second, and finishing third, I believe, was Giacomo and Sun King. Jeremy Rose, an up-and-coming jockey, had a really anxious moment there at the top of the stretch. He's not anxious now. He is euphoric.
Well, Tom Durkin, that was a scary moment. And Jeremy Rose, his first Preakness ride, it had been his first Derby ride also. Here's what happened with Scrappy T, who blew the turn, and I thought the jockeys were going to come out of the saddle. Blowing the turn, Dominguez pulling on his left rein, and behind him, a Fleet Alex going to his knees. How Jeremy Rose stayed aboard, I don't know. But not only does he stay aboard, but he gathers himself, the colt gathers himself, and wins going away. Is this colt tough or what? The Fleet Alex gang watched the incident at the top of the stretch. You can imagine their thoughts when they saw their horse just about go down. Here's the Fleet Alex gang.
Come on, Alex, come on!